Today we have 5 questions for interior designer Sarah Mendel of Cochineal Design. I'm Ariana in Seattle.
And I'm Peter in New York City, and you are watching Shelter. So today we're super excited because we have Sarah Mendel from Cochineal Interior Design with us in New York City. We've been trying to get Sarah to come to our show for the longest, and so she finally said yes, and we're going to have some great questions. I know she's laughing because she knows. we're going to have some great questions for her, and Ariana is going to start with the first one. So thank you, Sarah. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, Sarah. So question number one, what do you find is the best way for you to get inspired?
It's a great question. When I love something, I get really excited by learning more about it. For instance, last night, I really went down the rabbit hole looking at this beautiful piece of ceramic by Gunnar Nyland. It's a beautiful form, and I love the colors and the textures. But then it's, okay, well, I want to learn more about what was the breadth of his work. I was looking at a vase, but he did teapots and, you know, all sorts of things. And who were the partnerships with? How is it made? And then you kind of like deep dive even further, who are dealers that represent him or galleries? And then you're learning about new sources and, you know, who are his influences and heroes? And I can just geek out on these things, but it really energizes me. And that sort of immersion process gives a piece meaning. And that to me is inspiring.
For me, a lot of it is storytelling that opens you up.
Absolutely. Okay. That's what gets me excited.
When working with new clients, what are the questions you ask them?
That's a really crucial question. Before we start any project, we have a pre-design meeting with the client, and we ask a million questions, and we show them a million pictures, but we ask lots of questions that sort of key in on what are their lifestyle needs, so that we're designing to maybe they're expanding their family, or now they're working from home, you know, and schooling from home. And so it's addressing the needs of a family in a household. And then, of course, many aesthetic questions. And those we really sift through going through images. And then at the same time, we have to discuss the practical things, timeline, budget. You know, those aren't as fun, but they're really crucial to having a successful collaborative partnership.
It's not just about choosing pretty pieces for a home, right? It's so much more than that. Next question for you is, how do you create a sense of balance in your projects?
It's actually very intentional. My studio director, Risa, and myself have spent the last few years coming up with what we call design principles. We approach every project and every client as a unique opportunity, but we do want to have some sort of line that carries our work. We call it a sensibility. And so when it comes to tonality, we like every room to have a balance of lights, tones, medium tones, and dark tones. And those medium tones are very often natural materials. So woods, leathers, metals, something to really warm the space. We never have, and I don't want to say we never would, but you wouldn't expect to see a monochromatic room come from Cochineal Design. We're not creating rules that we can't break, but we're at least creating sort of principles and guidelines that kind of tie our work together and are representative of how we feel about decorating.
So is that what you would call the Cochineal philosophy?
It's part of it. Sure, we have several principles, but that is definitely one that drives a lot.
Okay, so what are your favorite brands right now? What are the things that you're gravitating towards and you say, I want to have one of each in every color?
We like to work with 20th century vintage pieces a lot. So when we're looking for contemporary and new brands, we're typically looking for brands that we think mesh seamlessly. And it's to give a timeless look, but also a current look. One of them is Nordic Knots, which is a Swedish rug company that we love.
We all love them.
Yeah. Beautiful. It's great quality. And then another one is Trunk, T-R-N-K, and they're based in New York. The brands they represent, as well as their own line, really play well with sort of juxtaposing old and new, and even styles in terms of modern or raw. And then at a very high end, there's a company we work with called Roman Thomas, who does custom upholstery and beautiful case pieces. And I mean, they're really just the creme de la creme. And they sort of have a modern take on a traditional style, and their pieces blend beautifully with our vintage favorites. We love to include a Prouvet or Carl Momsten or Jean-Michel Frank, you know, these 20th century masters.
I love that about your work, your really strong sensibility.
Thank you.
We absolutely love the work that you do for your clients. So we are just dying to know, how do you decorate your apartment?
I actually just moved. So it's a great question. It's really relevant right now. I live in a pre-war building in Greenwich Village. For those of you familiar with New York City, it's downtown. So the building has a lot of sort of European references, and it's just got a lot of old world details. And so my first thought was to use something really contemporary to balance that out and kind of flash it out, actually. So the first piece I bought, which was during quarantine at auction, so sight unseen, was just a really big piece of abstract statement art, and it will live over my very ornate fireplace to sort of tone it down and balance the old world and new world, which is something I love to do.
That sounds great. I just love the idea of being the architecture intact and then just adding pieces that are not necessarily what you would consider of the time of the architecture and actually make that balance. I think that's really, really empowering in any room. You need to tell the story about who you are, right? With your furniture and your art.
Yeah, and I think to your point, you start with that architectural context, and it doesn't mean you have to match it, and it doesn't mean you have to rip it up and do a white box or something. And so furniture really gives you that opportunity to play with it and to make it more current or make it more playful, whimsical. I love a sense of whimsy in a room.
Yeah, me too. What's your favorite flower?
Oh, I have one. That's such a great question. I love calla lilies, and I have very dark, dark, deep purple calla lily bouquet behind me, and I have orange ones in the bathroom. My house is full of calla lilies.
So we have to know, where did you get those beautiful calla lilies?
So I have a florist right here in Greenwich Village that I love called University Flowers. And I actually have a weekly order to always have calla lilies delivered. So, I mean, it's very special and I love that they offer that.
So rumor has it in the industry that you know a thing or two about dynamite. Is this true?
It's a little bit true. Anything about chemistry, but we're doing a project on a lake in Connecticut, and it's pretty treacherous terrain. And so we actually had to dynamite a whole acre almost. There were no trees killed. This was just a hill in order to build this enormous house that's going up on a lake. And we're so excited about it, but it was pretty cool to see the explosion.
All right, Sarah, thank you so much for joining us on Shelter. It was so nice to have a chance to chat with you, and we'd love to do it again sometime.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. This was really an honor, and you guys are so much fun. Thank you.
Thank you. We could talk for hours. Thanks for coming.
Bye.
Wow, wasn't that great, Ariana?
That was so amazing. I love talking to Sarah, and her work is so gorgeous.
I know. So I hope she comes back, and I hope you come back to watch us next time, whether it's a video or some crazy shenanigans we are going to get into. Of course, all about interior design. So I'm Peter in New York City.
And I'm Ariana in Seattle, and you have been watching Shelter.